Hi, and welcome to the Asseily podcast. I'm Chris Torrance. In today's episode, I want to tell you about a brand new product that I have in my store. It's the Disc 2 Reanalog card. So let's get started. Today we want to talk about the Disc 2 Reanalog card. This is a brand new project from Karl KKR75 Asseily. It consists of two boards that completely replace the boards within your old Disc 2 drive. There is the main card, which replaces the analog card within your Disc 2 drive. And then there is the motor control board, which replaces the board on the back of the Disc 2 that controls all the motor functions. The original Disc 2 analog card was designed by Steve Wozniak at the end of 1977. It was a brilliant piece of engineering and used state-of-the-art components. However, over the years, many of these components have begun to fail, either through simple wear and tear or perhaps when someone plugged in the ribbon cable off by one set of pins or off by an entire row. If you're only occasionally using your Disc 2 drive with your Apple II, this isn't really a big deal, but if you're trying to use something, say like the Applesauce floppy disk controller to actually copy or archive disks, then it becomes critical that you have a fully functioning and optimized analog card in your drive. The new Disc 2 Reanalog card solves all of these issues. You can see that everything is using surface mount components. The only real exception to this is the MC3470 amplifier chip. Karl Asseily actually did some tests and found that that chip performed better in its original package form compared to more modern replacements. Moving to more modern components has several benefits. For example, the newer components are going to draw less power compared to the older ones. The extra real estate also allowed Karl the chance to add a few nice components. For example, there is a jumper switch now for write enable, which I'll talk about a little bit later, as well as several control points where you can attach leads to measure signals off of, say, the 74LS125. Let's go ahead and install the new boards into my Disc 2 drive. You can see I have a new case on this one. This is the clear case from MacFX. The new analog board will work in pretty much any Disc 2 from back in the day, including the official ones from Apple, such as this one here, or any of the clones from third-party manufacturers. The first thing we need to do is just remove the four screws on the bottom of the case. Now that we have the screws out, we can flip the drive over and then just slide the case off. Removing the analog card is straightforward. We just need to remove this plug here, and that just slides off. And then we need to remove the ribbon cable. That's sometimes held on with a small retaining clip, and you just need to pop that straight up from the housing. Yours might not actually have that depending on its vintage. And then once that's off, we can just pull out the ribbon cable. The last plug to remove is the large one that carries all of the signals from the analog card to the rest of the drive, including the motor control board. This is typically held on by two small plastic tabs. If you just carefully slide the plug back, the plastic tabs just pop off. Finally, you just need to remove the two screws at the front of the card. After removing those, you should be able to just slide the card forwards and out. To get to the motor control board, we're going to need to take the bottom off the drive. First thing I'll do is remove the ribbon cable from the plastic housing. You'll notice that my drive also has the Applesauce sync cable. Most drives typically won't have this. Flip the drive over and remove the four remaining screws on the bottom. This Disc 2 drive is actually from someplace called Colorado Computer Systems in Westminster, Colorado, so not too far from where I am. The motor control board is held on by two screws, so we just need to undo those. Once we've taken those out, then we just need to detach the wires that are going to the board. The new board actually uses a terminal block, so that'll make it just a lot easier to install. Let's go ahead and remove the two screws. be careful because behind each screw is an aluminum spacer, so don't lose that. We'll need it when we install the new board. To detach the motor control board, you can either cut the wires and then strip them, or you can do what I'm doing here and just use a desoldering iron, which is just a little bit neater and saves you the trouble of having to strip the wires later. Now we just need to insert the wires into the terminal block on the new board. One important point, the black and blue wires actually get jumpered together into the same terminal. After that, we just screw the board back on, making sure to put the spacers behind each screw. Just like the original board, the new motor control board has a speed adjust screw on the side in case you need to slightly tweak things to get it up to 300 RPM. After that, we just screw the bottom back on and flip the drive over, and now it's time to install the re-analog card. So we just slip it into place and plug in the cables. One note about mounting the ribbon cable, the connector on the new board is at a slightly different angle, so I wasn't actually able to use that little plastic connector that was on the old board, but you really don't need it, so you can just leave it aside. Just like the original analog card, the new board doesn't have any sort of shroud around the 20-pin connector, so just make sure that you have all the pins aligned when you're attaching the cable. Now it's time to just feed the ribbon cable through the plastic mounting bracket on the back and close everything up and try it out. I've got my disk drive plugged into the applesauce unit, and then I'm running the applesauce client on my Mac. Let's go ahead and go over to the diagnostics here, and the first thing we'll do is just the speed test to make sure that's close. All right, so first of all, good news, the drive is actually spinning, which means it's getting the signals from the applesauce into the drive unit, and it's controlling the motor. We have a speed of 299 RPMs. I've already got my screwdriver positioned in the little screw here, so then you can see as we turn this, we can get the speed to 300 rotations per minute. Oop, wrong way. Okay, that looks good. Let's stop that. And now we'll just click the check drive. Okay, and it wants a formatted scratch disk, so let's just go ahead and put that in. I got an X on the write protect check, but that's only because I've disabled the write protect switch on this disk drive. One cool thing about this new analog card, it has a jumper here. In the normal position like this, then it will follow the write protect switch of your actual drive. If I move the jumper over to the left two pins, then it will allow me to write any disk, including a write protected disk. So that's nice because then you don't have to manually modify your disk drive to enable that. If I remove the jumper completely, then it will disable write, so you'll never be able to write to floppy disks. There's a couple other trim pots here on the card, and these allow fine tuning of the MC3470 amplifier chip. By default, the settings that come with the card are perfect for reading and writing regular Apple II floppy disks. However, if you're going to be using this with an applesauce, like in this case, you can actually tweak these and completely fine tune it so that you get perfect reads and writes using applesauce. I don't have time in this video to cover how to do that fine tuning, but maybe I'll do that in a future episode. I've got my disk 2 plugged into my regular Apple IIe now, and let's see how the new analog card does with a regular 5 1/4 inch floppy. So I'll just put the disk in and turn it on. Okay, and you can see that everything boots up, looks great. We can go ahead and run any of these games. Okay, and so it looks like it loaded everything up okay. It actually seemed a little bit quieter even than regular, so I don't know if this card is just a little bit more efficient at actually seeking and running the motor, or if it's just my imagination, but it did seem like it was able to access everything just a little bit faster. I hope you enjoyed this tour of the new Disc 2 Reanalog card and kit. I'm going to be carrying this in my store, and I'll put a link in the show notes for where you can purchase the kit. Also, I have a Patreon if you'd like to support me further, and I'll have a link in the show notes to that as well. Once again, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. I'd really appreciate that. And thanks for watching.